Welcome. This is Sports This Morning, reaching you live from Channels Television Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. My name is Austin Okonakpan. Welcome. Action packed World of Sports. Let's dash to the NFF Secretariat. What's going on with Coach Stephen Keshi, the Nigerian Football Federation, and Vincent Enyama? Talks have it that Vincent Enyama has explained that he did apologize to the Nigerian Football Federation for not turning up at that disciplinary committee hearing. But the Nigerian Football Federation says there's nothing as that the Nigerian captain needs to come out and give a public apology. What's going on with the Nigerian Football Federation, Coach Stephen Keshi and Vincent Enyama? We're waiting to hear from Coach Stephen Keshi and the verdict that the Nigerian Football Federation will give as regards the talks about the coach of the Super Eagles. Okay, all of that talk when Vincent Enyama raised concerns that security in Kaduna should be thoroughly looked at before the game between Nigeria and Chad is actually not a major concern to the Nigerian Football Federation, because the Super Eagles of Nigeria will be going back to Kaduna to play next year's qualifying game against Egypt. That game will come up in March, and the Nigerian Football Federation says Kaduna is the place for the game. And I think Kaduna gives good support to football, and the Super Eagles should start learning how to play football right there at the Ahmadu Bello Stadium in Kaduna. Let's play football now and talk about boxing. Yes, boxing has been a sport that has given glory to Nigeria over the years. But in recent times, there's no attention whatsoever given to the sport. And the former Commonwealth welterweight boxing champion, Obisia Wakpa, he has seen everything. Obisia has been a coach, Obisia has been a boxer, Obisia has been an administrator. He says the National Sports Commission are killing the sport of boxing in the country. We're getting ready for the All Africa Games in September in Congo Brazzaville, and yet no preparations whatsoever. He says, stop killing the sport of boxing. And I think that's the message that the Nigerian National Sports Commission needs to hear this morning. Quickly, let's go and talk about the Copa America. Chile, they're dreaming. The story, two red cards for Uruguay. A late goal by Mauricio Isla has sent Chile to the semifinals of the Copa America for the first time since 1999. Now, let's see. Chile, they have never won the competition. This time around, they're hosting. Can they dream and make it a reality? Chile continues to march on at the Copa America. We'll talk about that extensively on the show this morning. Let's come back to Nigeria now. And it's worrisome when we talk about this all the time. For countries to do so well in sports, adequate preparations must be guaranteed. We're getting ready for the All Africa Games, and a lot of sports and federations are slipping. Weightlifting, nothing. Volleyball, yes, they just played the qualifiers, they've qualified, but we're yet to hear what's going on. But boxing has been a sport that has religious following in this country. I mean, before independence, Nigeria has already produced world boxing champions. I mean, Ogun Kid Bassey will be wondering what's going on with the sport. What are they doing to it? We have champions such as Jerry Okurududu, but right now, boxing is terribly asleep. And former Commonwealth champion and coach of the national team, Obisia Wakpa, he's saying, what are we doing? Why are we killing the sport of boxing in Nigeria? Just after the Commonwealth Games, well, Nigeria went there and got three bronze medals at the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, Scotland last year. Coach Tony Konyegwachi said the same thing, that there are talents in this country, but we need to start giving them attention for them to shine. We'll call back that talk with Coach Tony Konyegwachi. Let's listen to him. It'll form the basis for the discussion this morning. Sports This Morning on Channels Television. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Stay.
Efe Ajagba came as a surprise to everybody. Those that know boxing very well don't know he's not always been in the scene. Where did such a talent come from?
No, just a talent. I've noticed him because of his height, and he had got the heart. Actually, this is his first outing in his life. I've never gone anywhere before, but this is the outing. And I thank God. It's the training. I put it, like push him up, that he can do it, and he did it. He won the semifinal fight, clear winning, but they just robbed it because we have no referee or judge. So I only pray for God. If the NSC can sponsor our referee so that they can be certified, it will be great. You know, we are moving forward. Next time, you know, we need training tour. What these boxers lack is the exposure to international competition. They expose them, they will get more. Like this guy now, we didn't go in. We only trained for 3 weeks. 3 weeks for these Commonwealth Games. And you see country there, they've been in Cuba for 6 months. So if they expose this boxer, we bring gold back to Nigeria. The glory of boxing will come back.
And that's what we want, Coach Tony. We want the glory of boxing to come back to Nigeria because we love the sport. And I think boxing fans are not happy with the state of the sport in the country. You listen to him, the talents are there. Ife Ajagba, lovely talent. They're also good boxers coming up the rank, amateur and professionals. But the National Sports Commission, you see, it's not just table tennis. Now we see it's a system problem. We need to fix it for sports to shine in this country. Before we started talking about football, there was athletics. There was table tennis. There was boxing. Now it's just football. National Sports Commission. Coach Tony Konegwache is saying again, there must be training tours. There must be good coaching. He also mentioned referees. It's a total package. We need to start doing what is required to make sports shine. You don't just expect athletes to go to a competition and say, hey, you must win gold. It's not rocket science. It's not a miracle that the guy will just go and fight a boxer that has been preparing for years for that particular fight. And now, the Commonwealth Games, so much time from the Commonwealth Games till September, when the All Africa Games will start, nothing for boxing. Absolutely nothing. We've just been quiet. We need to change this. This must be fixed. I want to bring you into this. Let's be part of nation building. What can we do in this country to fix sports generally, not just football, sports generally? Because the talents are right there. You listen to Coach Tony Konegwache. Email if you want to. It's sportsthismorning@channelstv.com. Let's fix sports in Nigeria. And we can't do it if the National Sports Commission is not ready. I think we should put a call across to Mr. Alassane Yakmut. We need to fix other sports in Nigeria. Nigeria is not just known for football. We're doing so well with athletics. Let's fix it. Let's consolidate. We're doing so well. We can even do well in swimming if we give it some attention. So that's it. We have to set the agenda this morning. Sports must shine again in Nigeria. Well, before then, let's just also let you know that there's still talks coming out of the glass house. Coach Samson Siasia is also not excited with his players. Come on, guys. The coach has called for camp and nobody is turning up. Let's turn up. Let's give him all the best, the Olympics qualifiers. Tayo Salam joins us now. Tayo, good to have you on the program.
Austin.
I'm throwing through passes to everybody this morning. The National Sports Commission, Tayo, okay. Coach Samson Siasia, Stephen Keshi, Vincent Yama. You almost scored goals this morning.
I don't know about throwing through passes. Austin, I know, just going by your intro, you'll be training a lot of A-makers as well, too. So I'm ready to dodge and weave.
I'm giving the left hook.
Yeah, but don't.
Because I'm talking about boxing this morning.
You can't touch me. I'm getting my Mayweather defense on. But it's good to be on the show again, Austin.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah.
I see all of this talks, Tayo, and I think a lot of sports fans out there will be wondering, what's going on? What are we doing in terms of developing sports in this country? And again, it's the same talk. The NFF, same thing. Instead of us to start getting ready, look towards the future for the four corners. All of this issues, Tayo, what's going on?
I don't know what's going on, Austin. And like you said, we should be focusing on, you know, upcoming games now. The Falconets and the Super Eagles as well. So they'll be playing in Tanzania. I hope preparations will start really soon for those ones. And but then the issues on ground as well, they're there. And we're hoping they sort it out once and for all. And the Keshi issue and the Yama issue. Once that's sorted, then I believe we can move on with football in the country.
Okay. And for Keeper Vincent Nyama, I'll just read some of the comments he made after the Nigeria Football Federation summoned him for making uncomplimentary remarks for that game between Nigeria and Chad because of the venue in Kaduna. Vincent Nyama said, as the captain, I only raised our concerns about the venue before our game, which didn't go down well with the football authority. I was told to apologize for my comments, which I did immediately, and they told me that's fine. So if someone said it's fine, Vincent, if you apologized, but let's go back. Is there anything wrong for the skipper to say, my guys would like to know what's going on with the venue we're playing the game?
Austin, as a captain, sometimes the players look up to you, you know, to say some things. And Enyama has decided to come out and say what he said. But then the NFF didn't like it. They felt it was, they felt his comments, it didn't really go down well with the NFF. And so, but that's all settled and done now. But what we're saying now is, he was invited for this particular NFL and disciplinary committee. He didn't show up, and I heard before then as well.
He said online. That's incredible. That's no letter.
Exactly. So that's where I'm going. According to the NFF, they contacted him. So what are we going to believe here now? According to the NFF, he was contacted. He was actually queried before he was summoned to the disciplinary committee. So we have two different angles to the story now. So who are we supposed to believe? But besides all that, Austin, like I said, there's no point in dragging this thing off for too long. Let him come out with it, whether it's a fine, whether it's a couple of games and suspension, whatever it is, let him come out with it and let's move on. Austin, simple as that.
I totally agree with you, Tayo. It's about time. Let's just leave these. So Vincent Enyama, Coach Steven Keshi, NFL, we're not talking about it anymore. That's it. That goes right there. We're not talking about it again. Let it be peace. Let's keep our football do well, and that's what we're about.